The occurrence of febrile disease in children and adults is related to immunity. But despite this, different types of fever can also happen to a person. In fever disease types, especially internal fever has much different characteristics than others. We have compiled answers to questions such as what are the specific internal fever or how to lower it for you in detail. Under normal circumstances, the body temperature is between 36 and 37 degrees for adults. In children, this is higher than in average adults. This body temperature can change during the day. But despite this, in some cases this heat can rise much higher than normal. This condition usually occurs when the body catches germs or bacteria. It's called fire among the people. What is internal fever? What are its symptoms? It is caused by bacteria and viruses entering the body affecting a place called the hypothalamus. The reaction called internal fever is given by the body. In public, it's just called fire, isn't it? But, of course, it's much more than that. All these signs of internal fever are a kind of defense mechanism of the body. In other words, the same applies to the body as it defends a place in wars. The area defended is the body, and those who fight are harmful bacteria and the immune system itself. Internal fever is manifested by many symptoms. It kind of stimulates the body to protect itself. These symptoms, of course, should not be confused with different diseases. Because many different diseases can have the same symptoms as internal fever. These bacteria also appear as follows. Headache. Concentration disorder. Chill. Drowsiness. Shake. Tiredness. Muscle pain. November. Fatigue. Sweat. Increase in pain sensitivity. Abnormal increase in heart rate. What are the causes of internal fever? Normal conditions. Fire below 38 degrees of cold is considered normal. It's not necessary to go to the hospital. Despite this, if this fever increases every hour and lasts for a long time, you should go to the doctor. But the factors that cause this should also be eliminated as soon as possible. The first obvious cause of internal fever is caused by the body being infected. Especially in the upper respiratory tract, this infection directly causes internal fever. In addition, food poisoning is another factor. Consuming products that have expired can cause poisoning. It can also poison foods that are heated more than once. As a result of poisoning, internal fever is very likely observed. You don't eat food more than once, do you? How to reduce internal fever? Of course, if internal fever is observed, you should go to the doctor. But if it is unlikely to go to the doctor, some measures can be easily taken by everyone. For example, pharmacies have many drugs that are subject to this function. In addition, many of these drugs can be easily purchased without a prescription. Drugs such as ibuprofen, for example, are quite successful in fighting internal fever.